Great. I'll get another beer.
School. That's the weirdest reason I have
ever... Why'd you come?
grew up in the Bronx through slums with my mom, a series of bums. Guys who show all the ways and you fail. Got through law school, I busted my ass. Worked two jobs in addition to class. So forgive me for not winking at your tail.
Excuse me, just because you've got some kind of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder. And a big ass boulder. But the chance I can get I'm gonna be dreamer's head. I'm so close I can taste it. So I'm not gonna waste it yet. Chip on my shoulder. You might wanna get one as well.
Oh, I think that sounds highly negative.
Hey, I'm just being honest. When you weren't born into privilege, you gotta work twice as hard. And I want that sweatshirt back.
Wait! Two jobs? Lost law school?
I've been slept since 1998.
Seriously, how do you do it?
Well, I don't go to parties a lot. I could use the time that I got. Can't spend hours doing my hair or staying in shape.
I don't spend hours.
But I know it will all be worthwhile when I win my first look at a trial by my mom that grieving house out on the cave.
That's so sweet. No!
I put a chip on my shoulder. My father told her, with a chance I've been given, I'm gonna be dreaming of sales. Oh, I can't take the day off. I just think of a payoff. You need a chip on your shoulder. Little Miss Woods, come on.
No, I just need to prove to everyone that I'm serious.
No, what you need is to get to work.
Make yourself at home.
Stay up late studying?
What?
I said studying. You do study, don't you? Where are those law books?
They're under the...
Under the...
Under the pile of...
Pile of...
Next to the...
Next to the...
By the...
By the...
Oh! There. Oh, they're here somewhere.
You know, this that is real picturesque. But it started as blind as a test. Clear off, find some room for books instead.
What are you doing?
Can you live without this? Can you live without that? I don't know what this is.
It's my hair!
What the heck? Spend some time improving what's inside your head. Out, put it in storage, sell it on eBay, leave it behind. Out, what are you angry? Good, so get angry. You may find a chip on your shoulder.
Oh. legally the child's father, even though he was just a sperm donor. You are so adorable to think of me.
Oh, have you seen Viv anywhere? I've been looking for her all over.
Yeah. I mean, no.
Great. We're going to miss our flight.
Yeah.
Elle? Each time Warner walks through the door, your IQ goes down to 40, maybe less. And though it's hardly my business to say, could it be the real thing in your way is the very guy you're trying to?
Yes. I've been smiling sweet and thoroughly beaten, blowing my chance, but I can't shake him away.
He was clearly within his rights to ask for a visitation. Russell V. Sullivan.
Yes, but Russell was known to mother. Sullivan was just an anonymous donor.
But without Mr. Latimer's sperm, the child in question wouldn't exist.
Now you're thinking like a lawyer. Yes, Miss Woods?
Mr. Huntington makes an excellent point. But did the defendant keep a log of every sperm machine made throughout his life?
Interesting, why do you ask?
Well, unless the defendant attempted to contact every sexual encounter, defiant if the child was of no genius, he has no present claim on this child whatsoever. Why now? Why this sperm?
I see your point, but...
And by Mr. Huntington's standard, all masturbatory machines for the sperm is clearly not seeking an egg could be called reckless abandonment.
Miss Woods, you just won your case.
Oh my God.
Brilliant.